And number 22, Patrick DaCosta.
Go, boy.
And now for your Savannah Bees. Number one, the goalie, Josh Brown. Number two, Jordan Chambers. Number three, Taylor Katsanis. Number four, Naeem El-Harati. Number eight, Sergi Sora. Number 10, Jordan Trincy Line. Number 11, Theo Angus. Number 12, Jose Izurieta. Number 14, Inaki Uriz. Number 16, Will Oswin. And number 18, Alex Jamrose. The Bees are coached by Tom Melville. And they are assisted, he is assisted by Richard Langford. There will be no national anthem.
Scad, get the game underway. So Naki on the ball. Jordan Chambers first touch of the game. The right back. And it goes out wide left to Taylor Katsanis. Will Oswin get his first touch of the game. Back to Katsanis. It's a good start. Will Oswin goes down to... Good defending by the Georgia Gwinnett right fullback. It's a Georgia Gwinnett ball. Thrown deep in their own half. And Taylor picks it up. Will's going down that left-hand side again. Getting at him, he does great. It's a corner to Scott. Will Oswin gets up the traps well. It's a great start for the Scad Bees. Taylor Katsanis with the throw-in. It's Trincy's first touch. Just comes off his right shoulder, goes up for a good goal kick. Gwinnett play the ball up fast to the right fullback. He shifts the ball up long. Theo Angus picks that up with ease. Gone out for a Scad throw.
Hey, Aaron.
George Gwinnett, his right fullback has the ball, just goes easy to the centre half.
Hey,
a good move by Georgia Gwinnett. Starts from the centre half, he plays a good ball into their centre midfielder, who ends up pushing the ball up to the left winger, and the left winger gets a cross in, but Sergio Suarez deals with the danger. And it's a corner to Georgia Gwinnett. Georgia Gwinnett corner. Crosses to the penalty area, but it's a good flip. Oh, it's a good save by Josh Brown. That's a Georgia Gwinnett right winger. Great save by Josh Brown, the Bees goalkeeper. And it's a Georgia Gwinnett throw-in. Deep into Scott's half. Jordan Chambers takes a great touch and plays the ball up the line. Gives Jordan Trinity Lyons something to run onto. It's good pressure. And the left fullback for Gwinnett carries the ball out of defence and shifts it into the midfield. Plays a good ball out to the left hand side. It's been shift back into the middle. And it's a switch of play gone to the Gwinnett's right fullback. Gwinnett moving the ball quite nicely. And it's open in 10 minutes. Both teams just feeling each other out. It's a good challenge, but the referee blows for a foul. It's a Gwinnett free kick inside the Scad half. Free kick goes deep, and it should be Josh Brown's ball all day. Oh, but he spilt it, and it's 1-0 Georgia Gwinnett. The cross shot comes in from, I'd say, 40, 50 yards. Looks like an easy catch for Josh Brown, but unfortunately it slipped through his hands, and the Georgia Gwinnett right fullback was there to pounce on the mistake, and he's made it 1-0. Let's hope the Scad Bees can regroup and get into the game. Not the start Scad were hoping for. Sergio Suarez on the ball. Takes a couple of nice touches. Plays the ball into middle. But it goes nowhere. Georgia Gwinnett keeper goes long. And Naki wins a good header in the centre midfield. Good play by the Scad midfielder, Naeem. Hustling for the ball and wins a Scad throw-in. It's great play by the centre midfielder. Jordan Chambers with the throw. Goes long to Trinity. Trinity wins a flick. Sasse keeps it in. But he's met by the left fullback. Great challenge by AJ. Will Osmond's on the ball. But Gwinnett clear the lines once again. Naki's fighting for the ball, but Gwinnett threatened again, 20 yards out, it goes to the right winger, on the edge of the 18, tries to take on Taylor. It's a good shot, but it's a good save by Josh, and it's a goal kick to Scad. That was a good counter attack by Georgia Gwinnett, but Scad will end up dealing with the pressure very well. Goal kick to Scad. Josh Brown's decided he wants to clear his lines, and he pushes the players up, and he's going to go long with this goal kick. AJ wins a flick. Georgia Gwinnett once again pick up the ball with the right fullback and started very well. They'll just start again. Good pressure from Scad, forcing them all the way back into their own 18-yard box. And it's a switch of play. The Gwinnett centre half. They just keep ball now. This is good pressure. This is fine for Scad. Scad dealing with the pressure. Gwinnett just keeping ball. Passing the ball well. switch to the right full back. Now they're inside the Scads half. Will Oswin and Jordan defend well, and Scad possess the ball, and Naeem carries the ball into their half, plays the ball long, but that just dropped into the centre half of Georgia Gwinnett. Will Oswin receives the ball for Scad, as he goes on that left-hand touchline again. Plays the ball into the middle of Chernacki and out to Sasse Zaretta on the right-hand side. This is the first we've seen of Sasse. Cuts inside into his favourite left foot, pushes the ball out wide to Jordan. Jordan goes to Jordan Chambers. It's a good cross, but no one's there. And Gwinnett clear the lines for a throw-in and deep in their own half. That's much better from Scad. It's a great play. Sasse gets the ball. Cross him with his left foot. It's a good ball. Jordan turns the line, gets a flick on, but it's an easy catch for the goalkeeper. Keeper clears his line. Theo Angus is there with a good header, but unfortunately the referee gives a foul. It was a clear header, and Angus was hard done by for that decision. It's another Gwinnett free kick. Similar position to the first one, where they got their goal from, but just on the opposite side. It's now on the right-hand side. This time Scad deal with the ball. Naeem clears the Scad lines. AJ fights for the ball. Jordan Chambers gets the ball down. And it's a Scad free kick. AJ manhandled inside the Scad half. Sergi Suarez with the Scad free kick. Looks like he's going to go long. He's looking short. He's got so many options, so he's took the long ball. And AJ crossed to win the header. Gets a good touch. Passes the ball to Sasse. Sasse's had a couple of good AJ. Jordan on the head. Great ball by Naeem to go out wide to Will. Will Oswin gets across, but he doesn't beat the first man. And the right full back for Gwinnett's there again. Georgia Gwinnett give the ball away. Taylor Casanis with the Scad rope. Great skill by Jordan Trinity line. But unfortunately, he doesn't quite make the pass off, and Gwinnett come out with the ball. They've gone long, but Sergio Suarez is there sweeping. Great play, great skill by the Spaniard. And Naeem is on the ball. Plays it easy to Taylor, and they go up the left-hand side. Unfortunately, the ball just got played too far to the right of AJ, and Gwinnett receive the ball once again. Bar the goal, it's been a pretty even first 10 minutes of the game. Possessions 50-50. Jordan Trinity line gets played over by Theo, hassling the Gwinnett's defence, but it was cool play by the centre half, who just rolls the keeper in and clears our lines. Well, Naki picks the ball up in the middle, goes up to Taylor. It's good possession. Back inside to Naki. That's a free kick. Naki remained calm under pressure there, did very well winning the free kick for the Bees. Theo Angus will be the taker of the free kick. Free kick's just on the halfway line. I think he's going to test the defence. He does, he plays a long ball. Jordan Trinity line wins a flick, but just rolls through to the Georgia Gwinnett keeper. He fires the ball out to the left fullback. Oh, that's a terrible pass by the left fullback. Gives Scad an easy throw. Jordan Chambers on the ball. Gives the ball to AJ's feet. AJ plays it back. Jordan Chambers plays a clever little ball in behind the right fullback, but he's there to he clears his lines well, and he carries the ball out. Play the ball to the centre fielder. It's a switcher play. The right fullback for Georgia Gwinnett carries the ball up into the Scad half, but decides to start again and rolls in the right back. Georgia Gwinnett keeps possession of the ball. Switch again. It's a great ball, but Sergio Suarez is there to clear up again. Excellent play by the centre half. Cesar Zareta on the ball. Goes into his left foot. Plays the ball up wide to Inaki. That's a free kick. Inaki was fouled once again. Georgia Gwinnett seems to be happy to give these fouls away. On, I'd say, the halfway line. Maybe a little bit into their half. But they like to break the play down and they're not letting Scads move the ball. It's a great ball by Chambers out wide to Inaki. It's a good cross, fired across. AJ gets a shot off, but it's a good block by the centre half. And Gwinnett come away. This could be a counter attack. But it's a good challenge by Sasse. Plays the ball the outside of his foot over the top. It's a great ball as well, the outside of his left foot. Jordan gets a shot off. Oh, that was close. It's a great save by the Georgia Gwinnett goalkeeper, but a great move by Scad. That's much better from Scad. It's what we want to see. It's a B's corner. Will Elswin goes over to the right hand side to whip the dangerous ball in with his left foot. It's pretty static in the box right now. Let's see if we're going to get some movement. There we go. Looks like it's going to be a front post call. Plays a great ball into the penalty area. Oh, that's unlucky. And it's gone out for a goal kick. Great ball in by Will Oswin. Great, great, dangerous ball. Gwinnett keepers in no hurry to take this goal kick. A bit more pressure from Scad, slowing the game down a little bit. That's much better from Scad. Gwinnett goal kick, met by the head of Will Oswin. Inaki getting stuck in. It's a Scad ball. Thrown on the halfway line. Taylor Katsanis goes over to take it. He's looking simple, but there's an option. He goes second, Jordan wins a good header, but it just drops into the centre midfield, into the George Gwinnett centre midfielder, and plays a simple ball into their centre half. Centre half plays a ball into the left winger. Good pressure by Chambers. Gwinnett eases the pressure by just rolling the ball back into the centre half. Given back to the goalkeeper and pushed out wide for the right back. Sergio Suarez gets the ball, doesn't have many options. Gets the ball again. Let's see if it's some movement. It's going to go second ball here. That's going to roll through to the keeper, but Chambers is. Chambers, good hassle by Chambers. But the left full back gets the ball for Gwinnett, pushed it into the centre midfield. This is where Gwinnett have been dangerous. The counter attack, but that's it. That was a panic ball by the Gwinnett centre midfielder and just gives possession back to Scad. Sergio Suarez is back on the ball. Plays second, good ball to Sasse's. Great, great ball. Sasse's first touch immaculate. And goes out wide to Inaki. Inaki with a little bit of space. Plays the ball into Jordan. It's a good touch. Inaki on the edge of the box. It's good defending. And Gwinnett come out with the ball. And they go out to the right winger. Haven't seen much of this guy yet. And he just lays it simple. Goes to the fullback. Georgia Gwinnett seem to be happy just to keep possession in their own half. They're not threatening much. They got a little bit lucky with their first goal. And they've just kept possession since in their own half. But whenever they've got in a threatening position, they give the ball away. not causing Scad much trouble at all. But they still lead the game 1-0. Once again, they get into Scad's half and give the ball straight to Scad, and Naki carries the ball out. Gives the ball into Naeem. He's slowly getting himself into the game a bit more now. Showing a good step over, but it's a good challenge by the right fullback again of George Gwinnett, who started the game very well. George Gwinnett keep the ball again. Now they're entering Scad's half with a bit more space. The centre midfielder. It goes over to the left winger. What's he? Cuts inside. Chambers sells himself. Sergi Suarez. Deflection. Just takes out wide for a corner. It was a vital deflection as that was heading goalwards. And I think that might have beat Josh Brown on his far post. So it's a vital stop by Sergi Suarez. The left fullback for Georgia Gwinnett comes inside and tries to bend it round into the far post, but as I said before, it was good defending. They were looking for handball, but it never was. Caught the right hip of Sergi and out for a corner. The ball comes over and Naki's there to get a flick. The shot comes in and it's a goal. Georgia Gwinnett, second goal. The corner wasn't dealt very well. It drops to their left winger, who just fires it through the crowd to make it 2-0. It's going to be a test of Scad's character now. They've been the better side, Scad, but they've just been caught on the break. Come on, the Bees. Restart. Will Osman getting down the left wing, as he did starting the game. We would like to see a bit more of that from Will. That's where he's most dangerous. He's back on the ball and he beats his man once again. And it's given away by AJ. And the Gwinnett centre midfielder bursts through and goes out wide. It's with a good ball. But their right winger can't keep it in play, and it's a Scad throw. I must say, Gwinnett have counter-attacked well. Scad play the throw, Jordan to the line, sandwiched by two players. Could have been a free kick, but the ref weighs play on. And goes back to the centre half. What Gwinnett have been doing? Keeping ball possession in their own half. He's got pressure by Naeem. Naeem hustling. It's great pressure. He's managed to win the ball. It's great pressure. And they've pinned him into their own corner. But it's a Georgia Gwinnett throwing. Sergi Suarez picks up the ball. That doesn't have a lot of options. But he plays a great ball over the top to AJ. But the Gwinnett centre half comes across and heads it away for a Scad throwing. Takes it fast. Young's on the ball. Like to see a bit more of Hill on the ball. And how dangerous he can be. Taylor bursts into the box. Goes that way to Will. Will in his favourite position. Plays it. Fires a great ball across. Oh! Just misses Naki's head and Sassi on the back post, but Sassi remains possession. The ball's out to Jordan Chambers. That's a great turn by Naki. Oh, that's unlucky. Sassi was unable to read the ball. Clever little pass that Naki played to him then. They just wasn't on the same page, unfortunately. That's much better from Scad. It's just over 20 minutes been played. And it's the visitors who are 2-0 up. Scad B is fighting to get back into this game. Sassi gets put out wide. He's going to come back inside with his favourite left foot. Which he does, he plays a great ball across. Oh, and it just misses Will Osman on the back post. That's better again from Scad. Scab play, they look very dangerous. Players are looking in great shape. So the SCAD team, it's one of the best SCAD teams I've seen over the last few years. It's looking very good. It's a great play by AJ, strong, strong play. Two men inside. Taylor Cassandra plays a great ball inside to Sergi. Sergi plays a great ball into Sese. This is better. AJ's onside. And it goes up wide. And Will Oswin, his favourite left, fires the ball across. Oh, but it's good goalkeeping. Takes that very well. That's much better from Scad. Now they're getting on top. It's giving the Georgia Gwinnett defence something to think about. And they seem to be struggling with the quality of Scad. Sharp passing. It's great football, soccer. And it's a pleasure to watch by the Bees. It's a good win by Taylor. Getting two big guys out of the ball. Great leap. Gwinnett now back in a dangerous position. Once again, Taylor Katsanas gets his body in front of the ball and mount and breaks down the play. It's gone out for a Georgia Gwinnett throw. Again, they start again. And it's a shot from 40 yards. Very ambitious by the number 8 for Georgia Gwinnett. And it ended up going 20 yards wide of the left hand post and doesn't triple Josh one little bit. It's a Scad goal kick, and Sergio Suarez has just dropped that wide for Josh, and Josh plays in the ball. Sergi carries the ball. It's a good ball inside. And Jordan Trinity Lyon dropping very deep there into his own half to get the ball, but keeps possession and just lays it back off to Naeem. Lays it to Taylor. Taylor lays it back. It's a good ball by Naeem. Fires it into AJ. AJ goes out wide. Oswin's just unable to keep it in play. That's a good move by Scad. Lucky. Gwinnett clear the lines, panic. Jordan Chambers picks the ball up in the Gwinnett half. Clever ball, but good defending. And here they come again on the left wing. Chambers has been caught out. He manages to trap that. But there's room in the middle for Gwinnett. And they go out to that wide right again. And the danger's not cleared yet. We're on the edge of the 20 yards. Has a shot, but that's gone in with the horses. Well over the fence. Sergio Suarez, switch. I'd like to see more of Angus on the ball. I was fortunate enough to play with Leo Angus, and what a top, top player he is. Playing centre half today, pretty much slotting anywhere. He played every position when I played with him. Left wing, left back, centre midfield. Did a great job wherever he played. Great, great player. I'm also the SCAD captain this year. Familiar face on the sideline as well, Richard Langford, assistant coach now. Seems to be enjoying the role. Obviously he's missing playing, but doing a great, great job as the assistant coach. restart. It's Georgia Gwinnett keeper. See, they're in no hurry now, Gwinnett. They're happy to keep the ball, even in their own half. Just playing it from one full back to the other. Here they go again. No pressure. But once again, they come into the stand half and just give the ball away. And it's a scab throw in the Jordan Chambers. Naki comes short, but goes unnoticed. So he goes second to Jordan 20 line. Great touch. And turn. And it's a scab free kick. Just a little over 25 minutes. It'd be nice to get start to get a goal in the next couple of minutes, especially before half time. Get them into this game. Sassy's on the edge. Jordan doesn't read the ball. Sassy played into him. So he just picks it up. Very cool at the back. Josh plays it out to Sergi Suarez. He's almost playing like a right fullback there. Plays the ball long, second. AJ fights for it and he wins it. Well done. Well done, AJ. Great skill by the young lad from Alabama. Will Osmond tries to turn. It's a shot by Jordan. And it's a penalty. It's a handball. It's a shot from Jordan 21. Comes off the left hand of the Gwinnett defender. Clear penalty. The Gwinnett's manager and the players are arguing that it was ball to hand, but it was blatant. It's a definite penalty. And it looks like Jordan's going to step up to the plate and hopefully get a deserved goal for the Bees. They have been on top in the last 15 minutes and this is deserved. So now we just wait. Rookie of the year last year, sophomore, more experience now, in charge of the penalties. Let's see if the number 10's got, goes to the keeper's left, keeper goes right, 2-1. Let's hold our scab back in the game. Better from the Bees. Cool, calm and collected from the sophomore, sending the keeper the wrong way. Great stuff by the Bees, back in the game. Come on, Scott. The Grizzlies travelling supporters not too happy with the call for the penalty. But as I said, it is a blatant handball. When it get the game back underway. Let them have the ball in their own half. That's good play by Gwinnett. He's in one on one. But Jordan Chambers gets his body in well this time. It's a snap shot. It's a snap shot by the left winger, but drags the ball wide of the far post of Josh Brown's goal. But it was good play. Good counter attacking football by Gwinnett. Scab just fell asleep a little bit after the goal. But it's good. Young Jordan Chambers got his body in well there. But he just got rolled a little. It's going to clear the lines. The big German, Oliver, is on now playing centre half. Gets his first touch of the game. Scad's shape looking much better now. As Gwinnett once again possess the ball in their own half. Not really threatening much. Happy to keep the ball there. Scad happy for their centre half to have it. That's a good ball by the George Gwinnett right full back. But he's offside. Clearly off. The the official didn't put his line, his flag up. But Scabbrae with Naeem. Good feet by Naeem. Great feet. Release ball. And he starts again with the left fullback. Taylor Katsanis on the left-hand side. Does well. Turns two. Plays a great ball. It's good, good sock by Scab. And Naeem comes back inside, wins the ball. Good, strong play by Naeem, and he just pushed the ball out right. Good play by Sergi. Plays a good ball, but it goes unnoticed. And all of this, good touch. And a good ball by the German. Oh, AJ trying to put a skill there, and it nearly paid off. Gwinnett once again, roll the keeper back in, and are happy to possess the ball. Pretty boring play from Gwinnett. But Scott will be happy. There's no threat from right there. And they once again, when they play the ball out of their own half, they give it straight to a Scott player. Great play by Sasse. Great ball. But it's good defending by Georgia Gwinnett. Goes to the switch but gives the ball away. They've got some room in the centre midfield this time. And they go out wide to our left winger. And he's getting at Chambers. Chambers forcing left. Forcing left. It's good defending. Now the two's up. It's good defending. Sergio Suarez heads the ball away, but only as far as the centre midfielder, who switches to the right. To the right winger. Comes inside. Oliver comes across. Good defending. And they manage to get the ball out wide. Will twos up with Will and Taylor. And Scad win the ball. Naeem comes out, showing great strength again and great use of both feet. Well played, Naeem. Jordan gets one. Running one on one and gets brought down. It's a Scad free kick. Probably 40 yards out. Wouldn't mind seeing Theo Angus whip a ball in here. Just great effort. Maybe Sasse is going to go across, which he is. Oh, and we're seeing Sergio Suarez venture up for this free kick. Let's see if his height can give the Gwinnett defender some trouble. Him and Oliver seem to be teaming up. See if one goes front, one goes back. I have no idea who's taking the free kick. We've got four people ready to take it. It looks like Naeem. So he's going to go back post. And Naeem does play. Good ball into the penalty spot. Well, it's just cleared. It's out to Will. He's got time. Good touch by Will Oswin. Goes out wide to Naeem. Naeem comes back inside. Lovely little step over. He's give the ball up, but he wins it back with great strength again. But the pass is short and it's given up, and Gwinnett come out. Gwinnett looking dangerous again on the edge of the Scots 18-yard box. But Jordan Chambers is across there again. Good defending. Good defending by Jordan Chambers. A freshman from Northampton. We have about 11 minutes left in this first half. Scad looking better. Let's see if they can get another goal. We've got another freshman subbing in now for the seniors, Sasse. And on comes the gaffer's son, Torin Melville. He's had a great start. Troubled by a slight injury, but the first three games in Scad, he's got himself goals and got himself really involved, and he's doing great. And now he's fit and ready to play again. Let's see what this young freshman's got for us. Will Oswin's causing problems out on this left wing again. He beats his man. But good defending by the right fullback. And they switch a ball, but it only goes as far as Torin. Gwinnett receive the ball again inside, and they've gone for a switch. Taylor Katsanis is there to clear that up. Oliver clears the lines for AJ. Going out. Oh, it's a Scad. It's a Scad throwing right in the left hand corner. 10 minutes to go. Scad looking more and more dominant as the game goes on. But Georgia Gwinnett's counter-attacking still causes some slight problems. Scarlett are definitely dealing with these problems a lot better when they fit the open 10-15 minutes. Jordan does excellent to get across what a great substitution and a great goal. It's Torin Melville. Jordan's into line, there's a lot of hard work, flicks the ball across. Torin on the volley, on the left foot volley. Great finish, great composure, fires the ball into the left hand corner. What a time to score for Scad. 8 minutes left. That's much, much better from the Bees. Great goal by the freshman. Pleasure to watch, great football. Let's go, Scad. Gwinnett back to their keep ball in their own half, get into the danger area again and give the ball straight up. They need to be changing that. Scad are just eating that up all day now, making it easy for the Scad defence. Here we go, they're in the half again. Just tries to play a switch. It's a good switch this time, but Jordan Chambers gets across. It's a good touch. It's a good touch. Torin does well, very well, and just well played. Time. All right. Field gets it down. Field takes a bit of a shot to the face, but he shakes it off. Great feet by Jordan again. The way he's got a man on him, but he's just too strong for him. It's a good ball by Torin Melville. Started very, very well, I must say. Gwinnett come out with the ball. Chambers. This could be dangerous for Scad. They get the ball out. They do get the ball out to the left. The player, once again, he slows it down. Back in. Happy to keep the ball. And they get a switch. Centre field to switch it to the opposite side. And here they come. Gwinnett come up on the right-hand side. We haven't seen him down the right for the last, well, since the opening 15 minutes of the game. And they look dangerous. They've decided to go against using the right side as much now. And I must say they've looked a lot less of a threat since they've stopped doing that. 8 minutes left. Giving AJ a rest. He's worked very hard. A lot of his work goes unnoticed, but he works so hard off the ball. And it's a sophomore serve. On to replace AJ. Good feet by Jordan Chambers. Just goes out wide to Torin. Torin turns. Gets the ball inside Naeem. And Naeem gives the ball up in a dangerous area. He tracks back. Sergi Suarez comes across, but good defending by Sergi. He plays a good ball inside as well, and that's a free kick. Hear the familiar voice of Tom Melville shouting onto the pitch there. That's a great switch by Oliver. The ball comes out to on the edge of the box. He gives the ball up. It's good defending. And they go to the right-hand side. Taylor dives in, misses the ball. That's a good move by George Gwinnett coming up the left-hand side. But he's gone inside. The left, he's all left footed. He comes inside, makes life hard for himself, and just gives the ball to a Scad player. So Suarez plays a great ball inside, a great touch by Theo, who goes out wide left to Jordan Chambers. Chambers back into Seth. Great touch by Seth. It's a great battle, he's showing great strength. Trinity play. Oh, excellent ball by John Trinity Ryan. It's great to watch. It goes that wide to John Chambers, and Tom Melville's offside. That's a good move by Scott. It's much, much better. It's great to watch. Real good stuff from the Bees. that's a Gwinnett free kick. Straight back, keeping the ball in their own half again. And left back. There we go, there to switch. Trademark by their defence. Goes out to the right. Come back inside. Get into the half and give the ball away once again. Well, one thing I can say about George Gwinnett, they've been consistent. It's a good ball by Naeem. Since he gets a flick, tries to go out wide to Will, but it just falls short. But Gwinnett clear the lines and it's a scud. Yeah. It's 5 minutes left this half. Gwinnett keeper clears his lines. He's got some flip, but Naeem's there to clear up. Miscontrolled by Taylor, gives the ball up to Gwinnett. The centre midfield, he's got 10, 15 yards. He goes up to the left hand side. The left third back comes back inside. And they once again, centre back, so keep ball. And now they're in the Scuds half. They're going to give the ball up. They've kept the ball this time, but once again, the Gwinnett centre half gets the ball, not being much of a threat at all for the Scad defence, really. That's a great ball by the centre half. But once again, it goes out to the left. Scad dealing with the pressure well. Just going from side to side, not really getting far. George Gwinnett, and the start again. Scad will be happy with this. It's gone back to the centre half. Yes, it might be nice to watch possession. I'd like to see a bit more from George Gwinnett. We've gone back to the keeper now. Back to the right centre half. They've gone long, and yet once again that long ball just rolls into the path of Josh. Scad eat it up. I must say, the German guy's played well since he's come on, Oliver. Very composed. Good with both feet. Gives the ball away there. But that's unlucky. Started very well. Oh, and Seth does well. Oh. Get out of jail free card for the Gwinnett centre half there. That's better by Gwinnett. More in the Scad half now. Let's see what they've got. They slow the game, but once again, give it to the right fullback. You've got the Gwinnett bench screaming at him. Scad, once again, happy. Just absorb this pressure. Look for the counter tap. And they do it. That's better. That's better by Gwinnett. They get out far on the far right now. Play a ball across, but it's cleared. Excuse me, swallowed the fly there. Centre half of Gwinnett. Once again, they just keep the ball. It's good possession, but it's going nowhere. As you can hear their centre half there, shout, let the ball go. Back on the ball. The left winger makes a run, but goes unnoticed. Taylor Katsanis. Time. There's a long ball. Seth wins. Jordan Trinter gets the ball down. That's good football by Scott. Naeem comes away with the ball. Plays a great ball to Tom Melville. Just missed control, but it's unlucky. One and a half minutes of the first half remaining. Two early goals from Jordan Gwinnett. Scad fight back, but a much better team. And it's 2-2, and it's deserved. will need to work on the start of the game though. I've seen that there's been a few games where they've fallen behind. Great defending by Taylor Katsanas. Really, really good defending. About 40 yards inside the stud half. Slow things down again. It's good football, but I don't think he's going to keep that in. No, he doesn't. Tom Melvin. It's 20 seconds left. Jordan Chambers is just going to take his time here. Probably use the line. 2 seconds left. And he does use Jordan at the line. Jordan makes it hard to the centre half to run. Good talking. There's 5 seconds of the first half. And the game's all tied at halftime, 2-2. It's a good start for Georgia Gwinnett. Scad fight back into the game. Looked the better team overall. It's a good half from Scad.
Keep the ball up in the Gwinnett area. Trinity goes wide. I've got the ball, the linesman's flagged. Clear the lines. Flick on. Put my aims there. So, it's a good job the centre half defended that with Jordan. Was peeking on the back. Right, right side, and he does. Oliver reads it well. Tell you what, this lad's played well today. Bit of a missed pass, but he's read the game absolutely superbly. Great to watch, and John Chambers gets up the wing for the first time. Comes back to Torren. Torren plays a left footed ball. It's good by AJ. Had no right to win that ball, he made that ball his. Great feet by Theo. And AJ does well. Oh. Good pressure by Torren. He's given the ball away there, but the work rate for him to try and win that ball back is just great to watch. But it's a good switch by George Gwinnett, but once again they go back to the full back. To the centre midfielder. Oh, but they go inside this time.
Oh yeah, that's a better touch. That's more positive by George Gwinnett. So right winger, he's going to be going inside, so he's got left footed. There he goes. That's a ball away, good defending again. And it's Naeem this time. But they keep possession once again. But they keep the ball down the right and they give the ball away. And Will Osmond's come out to the right hand side. Have they had the switch? It looks like him and Tony Melville have had the switch. Plays a 1-2 there, trying to see them away. He gets booked. Full shoulder barge. 50-50 if you ask me. But the referee gives it a Gwinnett ball. Yeah, it's a good feat by the Gwinnett midfielder, the number 22. Keeps possession. And inside the Scots half, that's a great ball. Very, very clever ball. And Oliver got away with a bit of a curl there, I thought, and he got away with it, so that goes down to me as good defending. Bit of experience, lad a bit quicker than him. The pull of the shirt, slow him down, unnoticed. Thank you very much. Scott got possession, not the Taylor Casillas. Comes back inside. Sells on that window, couple. Gives the ball to Will. It's good pressure by George to get that in the scab half. AJ just been bundled over there in the scab half. And that's nice because when it started to play a little bit better now, so scab. Take the time here. We're getting some possession. Got Will Osmond here on the left hand side. AJ there once again. It goes Osmond 1-1. This is where we like to see him. And Peter, good defending, but he hassles him. Osmond's hassling. Did very well. It's nice to see Will Osmond 1-1. The ball didn't come in, so it's a good one for him. Will Osmond had a bit of a tantrum there. AJ hustling again. Jordan Trinson just bosses the right full back with his body and just knowing what to do. Not happy about giving that one away, Jordan Trinson line. Stands in front of the ball, you've got to be careful, he's going to get himself booked if he carries on. I can understand his point of view. But he's only going to argue himself into the book if he carries on. But the two forwards battling hard and having a great, great game of soccer. There, Jordan again, running the header. Good challenge for Taylor, but Gwinnett pull away with the ball. And the right winger gets inside, pushing on his right. He's got to come on his left, which he does. Oh, he's shimmies too. And he fires into the side, netting. Scored the left lightly there. Both Oliver and Taylor. You can see that he was all left footed. They should have just pushed him wide on his right foot. But luckily Scad escaped that one. And it's a goal kick to Scad.
He's in the wrong way. But we're back. And Gwinnett possess the ball. Let me just get back into position. So I've just been informed by the technical guy. I've been talking to myself for the last 15 minutes. But we're back involved in the game now. Gwinnett keeping possession of the ball. Naeem comes away with the ball. That's a great ball by Naeem. Taylor Katsanis, and that's a free kick. That's mine. It's got to be in the book, yes. He's going to be shown a yellow here. And Taylor remains down. Are we going to see some action from Daniel, the physio? No, it looks like he's been told to stay. And the number six, the captain of Gwinnett has been given a yellow card. A rational play, definite free kick. It was a great move by Scud. Once again, they seem to have the favourites over the free kicks. You have Will there, Naeem. Naeem looks like he means business there with his shirt rolled up, showing his top arm muscles. Oh, they were going to go short, but they decided against it. He puts a good ball, hangs out a bit. It falls to Torin. Oh, he was after his second. But that one also goes in with the horses. But it was a good hit. Will Osman giving some direction there to the strikers. Gwinnett doing what they're best at. Just keeping the ball at the back. These two centre halves. They must have passed the ball between each other. Well, it must be 100 times. There they go again. Back in two. Very patient. But I mean, even after the patient build-up, we're not seeing much after that. There, once again. There they go. Giving the ball up. They'll stay patient. But until they get that second ball, the one where they're trying to play that second hole right, nothing's going to come of it for Georgia Gwinnett. But they're still in the game, as the game's still tied up 2-2. 10 minutes into the second half. See, Coach Langthorne has ventured out of the box. He might have some words to say. Tom Melville, the head coach of SCAD, remaining very calm, as always. George Chambers comes away. And that's a 50-50. And the ref is right to play on there. That's a good move by George. And they're on the edge of the 20 yards. Always onside. And it's a good save by Josh Brown. It was the left winger who came in 1-on-1. He's 1-on-1. All he had to do was put it right or left to Josh. And he goes straight at him. But don't take that away from Josh Brown, because it was a great save. Stayed on his feet well. Excellent, but SCAD get away there. Remains 2-2, and SCAD just haven't got out the blocks this half. Will, your head. Great touch by Will. There's no call there. It was a late call from Manon to Jordan. Good tackle by Taylor once again. Solid. That's a great ball for Hill. That's what we want to say. Oh, I tell you. Linesman, I'm level with that play, and he looked very onside to me. I'd like to see that on video again. It's the first time SCAD strung four or five passes together this half, and when they do, they look really dangerous. It's nice to see Theo. I'd like to see him involved in the game a little bit more than number 11 for SCAD. You know how dangerous he can be. And Gwinnett go back into their ways, just keeping that ball. I don't think SCAD will play a better team all year who can pass a ball between their two centre backs. There we go, he's let the ball go straight to a white shirt. I mean, you'd think they'd learnt by now. They've done it all game. Scatter just sitting there and waiting for that. That's better. Now they're playing defeat. It's a good move, and he remains on side, but you know he's coming on his left foot. Will does well. He's going to fire one up the line. Can AJ get there? Obviously gets his body in like he's been doing all game. Battling. Phil Angus picks the ball up in a dangerous position. Trinity's the centre half, as I expected, clears the ball into the swamp, gator territory. I won't be going for that one. Oh, that's a good 1-2. Referee. Oh, was that good or bad advantage from the referee? Bad from a SCAD point of view, as the ball gets given to the Gwinnett players. But here they go, centre half. I haven't got much else to say for Georgia Gwinnett, apart from they just like to keep the ball in their own half. Number six on the ball, plays that switch, puts him under pressure, starts again, back to the centre half. Oh. They give the ball back to SCAD. As soon as they get into SCAD's half, they give the ball up. Go on, AJ. AJ's chasing now against the Gwinnett big centre half, and AJ's got much better pace than him. He's one on one. He's waiting for someone. Oh, that's unlucky. He was alone. He did what he needed to do. Maybe he should have been a bit more greedy there. But I can't really say that the Alabama striker was to fault there. He was up there on his own. He did well. He took on the first man. Great change of pace. Left the centre half of Georgia Gwinnett for dead. Naeem was making the run, but he wasn't quite there. Maybe AJ should have been a little bit selfish there, and it could have been 3-2 to SCAD. Well, that's much better from SCAD. He possessed the ball well at the back, got it up the midfield, and got the ball across the face of goal. It's a dangerous play by the Bees. That's a great ball by Will Oswin, but it's good defending. But it falls to field on his right foot, fires one low. Oh, looks like we've got someone hurt. But SCAD, Will, swings one in with his right. Well, that's keeper's ball. I don't think we're going to get stopped here. No, they're carrying on with their man down. Yeah, it's been struck in the twig and berries there. But he shook it off. And they're back in possession. That's a great turn by the forward. Oliver jockeys him. But his the pacey forward gets up. Oh, and he's offside. That could have been dangerous. See a bit more lightning in the area. Hopefully it's heat lightning. 29 minutes to play. Josh Brown with a free kick in the SCAD half. Aims for Trinity. Trinity wins the flick once again. Absolutely bullying the centre midfielder. Oh, and I tell you what, that was close. AJ, his work rate nearly got him a goal there. And Jordan Chambers gives the ball up. But that's a great challenge by Sergi. Great challenge by the lad from Barcelona. Tell you what, he hasn't put a foot wrong today. Very solid. When he's needed to pass the ball, he's passed the ball well. When he's needed to be there for the challenge, he's there. What a great game this guy's having. But Georgia Gwinnett come away with the ball. And SCAD's half. Naeem's there. That's a good play by Naeem. Pass goes a bit astray, but Will Oswin keeps it in. Got Taylor on the overlap, but it goes unnoticed. That's a great ball by Oliver. I tell you what. Is Trinity going to? No, Trinity's not going to run for that one. He's going to save his energy, and probably a wise choice by the SCAD number 10. A couple of holes opening up now in the game. Giving a chance for a couple of the boys who are doing a bit more running to get involved. The number 8. And the centre half venturing. He plays his trademark ball there. Straight back to the SCAD. Oh. SCAD need to pick up. Jordan Trinity gets off. Will Oswin. Oh, it's a bad touch. It's unlucky. Centre half coming in once again. We've got the centre half. He carries the ball out. Let's see if he's going to play the long ball. Or is he going to? He's played the long ball. Give it straight to a Scad shirt once again. Great feat by Naeem. It's a double step over. He plays a great ball into AJ. Turns. Feel on his right foot. Fires across. Oh, I tell you what, that's unlucky. That's whiskers past the far post. Whiskers. And it was nice. Theo Angus gets himself. That's where he's good at. He's in them dangerous positions. AJ once again. It's absolutely superb. That's whiskers wide. That's great play by Scad. We need to see more of that. But once again, number three, let's see this guy's name. Georgia Gwinnett. Grohl Rood has been given the ball up left and right for Georgia Gwinnett, and Scad almost capitalised on it that time. Ball gets played long. There's a good flick on. Sergio Suarez is there, and a good hard challenge. Oh, and it's a snapshot. Oh, but Josh Brown. Okay. Josh Brown took a slide there. That was a great 50-50 from Sergi and the number 17 for Georgia Gwinnett. The Gwinnett midfielder coming out on top, but for the first time, Sergi's pretty much bossed him for the whole game. But now they come bursting through the middle again. And that's a good ball by the centre midfielder. And the right winger gets at him again. You know he's coming inside on his left. He gets a shot off, but that's easy for Josh. He was let onto his left foot a little bit easy then. But Josh receives the ball. He's going out to the left. Can we get Sefkin? Go on, Sef, get up. Oh, I tell you what, there's no advantage, RF. He's given a free kick on the halfway line, and AJ was through one and one. Was that a bad decision? Should he have let the play go? I say yes, but it's a Scad free kick. He was one and one then. He had his whistle in his mouth too fast there. Could have been a Scad goal. We've got Will Oswin out wide here hugging the touchline. I think it's going to be direct going around the penalty area. Theo Angus taking the. He's looking. He's got Will in his sights now. Is Will going to drop in and get this ball? No, he's going. He's gone for the switch. He's gone for Oliver on the back post where it lands. Gets it. Oh, it's a goal kick. Well, I've got to give it the officials. It's probably his. One and only bad decision of the night. They've done a great job. The linesmen, they've been on it, dead on with the offsides. And the official there. He's allowed one mistake. Sergio Suarez up, comes off the back of his head and cleared by Jordan Chambers. And the ball's back in the Gwinnett with Seth. There we go, it's a Scad ball deep in the Gwinnett half. Need to keep this pressure. We've got Cesar Zareta back on the field now. Good feet by him. It's a good ball as well. Oh. Ollie seemed to have his blinkers on there. We had Will shouting out wide. This is better from the Bees. 24 minutes left. Still 2-2. But Scad getting on top now. Goodbye, Taylor. Good feet by Will. That's a good ball, but that's good defending by the centre half. Good challenge by Naeem. Oh, Ollie slides, but just misses. This could be dangerous for Scad. But here he comes on his left foot. We've let him inside again. Oh, it's good. They're looking for a free kick. Who's that? Someone's hurt. Sergio Suarez is down. But Gwinnett aren't going to put the ball out. Josh Brown needs to put the ball out of here. I can't see who's down. It could be Jordan Chambers, actually. I think it is. Yeah, that's Jordan. Hopefully it's just a little bit of cramp and nothing serious. You see a few of the players on the sideline having a stretch now. Probably just cramping up a little bit. Will Oswin stretching his hammies. Some of the boys making the most of the water break here. Getting the liquids on board. Don't be fooled by it being at 10 o'clock at night. Still 80 degrees here. And it's hot, the humidity, as always, in Savannah. Always hard conditions. The boys obviously prefer to play at night because it just gives them that little bit of leeway. But trust me, I've played in these conditions, it's not easy. Not to mention the mats. And the game gets going again. And they've changed Jordan. Let's hope it is cramp, I'll get confirmation of that. But Inaki comes back on. It's nice to see this guy back in the game. And I will get confirmation about Jordan as fast as possible. AJ with a flick on. Tyler, that's a handball. No, the rest not give it. Just hold him there. Sergi's just been turned there. It's a good turn by the Georgia, but he gets back in. Just dived in there. Well played by the Gwinnett striker. He also made a good run off the ball, what goes unnoticed there. But they keep possession. That's better from Georgia Gwinnett. Nain comes out with the ball, plays there. That's a great touch. Oh, it's a good challenge. Sets in there, and it's a Gwinnett ball. That's the best Gwinnett have looked for the whole of the second half. It's took them a good 20 minutes to get going. AJ, he should be hassling this guy. Nearly a mistake by Rude there again. There he is, back on the ball, the number three for Gwinnett. There we go, he's kept it simple, he's kept to his limits. And the centre midfield's got some room, and he just sprays the ball out wide. And he's got 10, 15 yards of space in number 15 for Gwinnett now. But there he comes inside onto his favourite left foot. It keeps a good run going though. Oh, but the flag goes up. But Taylor doesn't give up on it. Even though the whistle went, Taylor was still back there. Great to watch. But that was good football by Gwinnett. And I'm not one. It was looking close if it was offside or not, but I'm on the opposite side of the pitch, so I don't want to call that. And I certainly trust the linesman because he's done a great job today. Josh Brown with a goal. Well, free kick. Goes straight down the middle. And it's just picked up by the number 23. There's number 17 for Georgia Gwinnett, who seems to be picking up the ball a bit more in there now. Just with a height advantage. Now Gwinnett, they've had a good 5 minutes of possession here. They haven't looked too dangerous. They've had that just that one giving goal, what giving offside then. But they're not giving the ball up as cheaply as they were. As I say that, they give the ball straight up. Josh Brown clears the lines. But the guy, he's got plenty of time to win it. It's good pressure by Sasse, but he's been beat by some skill. Feels in there to break the play down. And here he comes down the wing. The switch, but there's no one there. 20 minutes to play. Good little shimmy. Not the best of passes. He got unfortunate there, the number six. But that's a good ball. That's a great ball by the 19. It's a dangerous ball across. Taylor. As you could hear the Gwinnett keeper shouting there, it was a great ball. I agree, it was a great ball. But Taylor did very well. Kept track of his man, stayed with him, and made it hard. Was that a handball? Oswin gives a free kick away there and hobbles away. Could have got hurt there. Needs to be careful there, Oswin. Just shy of 9 30 here at the ground now with 19 minutes to play. Scores are tied 2-2. And SCAD did start the second half better, but Gwynedd have slowly started getting themselves in the game and they're probably looking the more dangerous of the two sides right now. They get a shot off, but it's cleared by, once again, by Sergio Suarez. SCAD need to push out here. They've played a ball out wide, but they're just a bit slow clearing the lines there. Sasse's got some energy, but the ball just rolls out. Gwynedd get receive the ball once again. They're enjoying a good spell of possession here, Georgia Gwynedd. And the right back picks up the ball. Number 12 goes inside to number 19, who's got himself in the game much better, but gives the ball away so cheaply there. And Maheen just collects that. And that's better from SCAD. Let's see something. Taylor carries the ball. Oh, that's a free kick. Players are shouting he got the ball, but I assure you he didn't. He got all man. The last one is out here on the sideline with me right now. He seems to be hobbling, but something must have fixed in his legs there because his ball's come to him. It's great skill, but he runs into danger. Oh, that's a ball, is it? Oh, I tell you what, referee. Turn. And they clear the lines. Sergio Suarez back on the ball. Good play. Number 8's having a good game tonight, as I said earlier. That's a great ball by Inaki, but not the greatest of touches from the number 23. Get wide. Will plays a great ball. And it's going to be a SCAD corner. It's a SCAD corner. I'm doing two jobs now. I'm the ball boy as well here. And it's a SCAD corner. Seth, the number 23, is going to take the corner. Or is Will? No. Will Osman takes him off the corner. He's going to. An outswing with his left foot. Changing it up. On a bit of a bank here, I can see. Makes it a little bit difficult. It doesn't make the front post. Oh, it's still dangerous. Comes out to Sasse. Push that wide to Inaki. Oh, he's dealt with that ball. Oh, he's got, don't want to see the, on the right, fullback, so he's got space, but it's a terrible ball by the Gwynedd centre midfielder. Taylor does very well there. Now Seth, come on Seth, let's see it. Beat him, he does beat him, goes inside, gets the ball out well to Naeem. And that's great football, that's unlucky. It's a joy to watch. Naeem, you swear that he's going to hit it. With just a little bit of a trick, Ronaldo. Would have been proud of that one. Gives it to Theo, but it's a bit of a miss hit and it goes wide of the left hand post. 15 minutes to play. That's better from SCAD. They needed to pick it up because Gwynedd were getting on top. All the claims and Will goes down the left hand side again. Plays a good ball. Oh, just a bit of a bad touch there. Bit of fight now, that's a good ball, that's a great touch as well by the Gwynedd striker. And he just goes wide, that's excellent play by the number 23. And they keep possession very well. And number 17 picks up, shoot, but it goes wide of the right post. A little bit too much space there from 25 yards out, yes. Maybe a little ambitious, but SCAD should have been a little bit closer there. Clock runs down to 15 minutes. And let's hope we see a goal here. And it's a goal kick to Josh, but we're just getting the change. Trincy's coming back on. It's great to see. And AJ gets a well-deserved rest. Ran himself into the ground. Jordan's first. Oh, and Ollie gets caught in possession. It's not a great place. Serge Schwartz needs to get across. What a challenge. Inaki, tell you what, give yourself a pat on the back, son. He read the play so well there, seen the danger, and he bust a ball to get across into the middle of the box there. I tell you what, when you see that back in video, well done, Inaki. That's great defending. Got one of the crowd being the ball boys as well now. I don't know where they've gone to. It's a good corner, but it's out by Will Oswin. Great touch by Sese and good play. Go on, get out, and this could be a good counter-attack. It's 4-on-3, 4-on-4. I just got Sese wide, and Nyaki plays. But it's good defending, and it's a scab ball. He's got some space. That's a good ball. It's a scab. There I go again. Back to my old job, the ball boy. Down here with the horses now. One, two with Taylor. Trinity plays a good ball. Oh, I tell you what, that's a bit of a push. The flag's gone up. So you give offside? Oh, I thought he made a rash decision of a penalty there. Hart skipped the beat, but it was for offside. I know. No, it's going to be just put online after. So. I'm under pressure now. And Inaki gets it, fires a ball into Sass feet. He deals with it well, but he just wasn't ready for the return, Inaki. And it's a Gwinnett throw-in. It's on this right on the halfway line. Striker remains calm. And Skag come away with the ball. Oh, but Seth gives that away cheaply. And that's a clever little ball the Gwinnett player's just played over the top. But he knows he's going inside. He does go on his right foot this time. Tail. Oh, he keeps it. But Naki's head to clear the line. Oh, it was Oliver, sorry, not Naki. And Taylor plays a great ball up the line. Good touch by Seth. He's got no one with him. Well played, well played. That's good play. Team up well there, Gwinnett. Good feat by the number 12. But Josh Brown's all day. Just over 10 minutes to go. Still tied 2-2 here. Bit of a late kickoff due to some lightning and the girls' game. So we had a 30-minute delay. We've got a great little crowd out here today. Probably close to, I don't know, 100, 200 people enjoying the game. Probably not so much the bugs. And it's the Gwinnett goal kick. Theo wins that all day. A little bit flat up top now, Skad. A little bit tired by the looks of it. It's
Good pressure. That's good pressure. It goes back into Josh's arms nice and easily. And 9 minutes left on the clock now. Could be a long evening. Could be going into extra time here. The way this has been going, it wouldn't surprise me if we do have extra time, which will be golden goal. Heartbreaking for the losing team, but what a feeling for the winning team. I remember a time last year out at Southeastern. It was deep into stoppage time, and the assistant, Richard Langfone, who was playing centre half, steps up, 30 yards out, free kick. I tell you what, he hits that ball with some venom and it flies off the top of the bar into the roof. And that, what a goal. We were going mad. And luckily, we were on the end of the winner's end of the game. And what a game. That was one of my favourite games I've had at SCAD. Anyway, enough of that. Back into the game. Judge of Gwinnett back in the SCAD half. Back to possession. Scott, let him have the ball there. But now I must say, the possession from the centre half is deeper into the Scott half this time. And that's a better ball. That's a great turn as well. Josh Brown does very well. Excellent. Brave keeping. I tell you, you wouldn't have guessed that this guy nearly had his teeth knocked out in training 2 weeks ago. He's as brave as ever. Goes in there head first, no problem. Wins the ball and wins a free kick as well. Great goalkeeping, Josh. Sergio Suarez carrying the ball out now. Plays the ball long. I tell you what, I didn't give Seth much chance there. He's won the header and a free kick. Excellent by the young lad. All of 5-5, 5-6. He's just beat a guy in the air. Probably 6-1, 6-2. And won a free kick. Well played. Scad got a free kick. Oh, I'm not sure it was there, referee. Well, it's on the halfway line, and I thought it was about 20 yards inside the half, but we're going to play from the halfway line. Tell you what, there's a bit. We've got some big boys up here now. We've got Oliver, Sergi, Trincy. Sergi's going to win it. No, it's flicked. That's a scat ball. Good decision. And Torrey Melville with a throw-in. Goes in for Sergi. Falls. Naeem's on the edge. Good feet by Naeem. They give a ball up. Gwinnett. Need to put that out. Oliver, don't let it bounce. Well done. And there's a Gwinnett throw up by the Scad halfway line. Oh, that was cheap. As you can see up there in the box is the Scad number 9, John McAleenan. Fortunately can't play. Just had scan results back. Good news. It's going to be a couple of weeks. First thought he did his hernia. Very upsetting news in the Scad camp. But anyway, it's great to hear that it was good news. And it's only going to be a couple of weeks and we'll get him back for the first conference game. So that'll be great for the team. Yeah, obviously he doesn't look too happy up there in the box, but always helping the team out. Not sure what job he's doing up there today, but he's doing something good for the team, I know that. Oh yeah, he goes looking through the binoculars. And Josh Brown is going to get the game back underway. It's 5 minutes left here. Looking like it, extra time. You never know. Trincy going for the header, but loses out this time. Sessa gets back. But the Gwinnett player's got some room. That's a great ball. It's great defending. Sergio Suarez once again, great defending, but it was a clever little ball played by the Gwinnett centre midfielder. But Sergio gets his body in front of the man and ball. Should I say between man and ball? He does a very good job. AJ's back on, being a nuisance. I
feel like they've missed him a little bit. It's been that type of game where, you know, it's pressing the centre half now, making him miss. Look at that. Excellent by AJ. Change of pace. I tell you what, this lad's fit. Quick and fit. He's had an excellent game today. He's been a pleasure to watch. That's good. Oh, that's unlucky. That's good by Serge again, but great touch by the Gwinnett striker. Very good touch. Look, AJ's running. It's taking a toll on him. He's down with cramp. And this is excellent to see. A Gwinnett player helping a SCAD player. Stretching him out. That's excellent. Great sportsmanship. And Gwinnett go the other side. Nearly score, but it's good defending by the big German, Oliver. But AJ's down once again. And the Gwinnett centre half, number six, is going across to help him again. And the goalkeeper. Oh, and the referee's coming across as well to stretch him. Everyone but the physio. Oh, Daniel's. Oh, he's just had the go. Here he comes. First appearance of Daniel of the night. Straight into the stretch. Oh, this is painful. Been through this. AJ having a good stretcher. And it's SCAD need to stay switched on here as it's a Gwinnett corner and the clock's not been stopped. I don't know if the official's going to add this time on. Oh, it's been stopped now. It's just delayed. Probably lost a minute of play there. Oh, and AJ looks like a ballerina there. He's back. He's up. Not limping too much. He's going to be grand. And he's on the jog. Well, we're going to switch him anyway. And let me just. Well, the confirmation you've been waiting for. Jordan Chambers is coming back on. So obviously, the knock he took earlier wasn't as bad as first expected. So that's great news for the Bees. And here he comes back into play. And his first job is going to be defending a corner with 3 minutes on the clock. It's a deep corner. Oof, I tell you. Josh came out, he missed it. And it's another corner. Some good pressure by Gwinnett here. SCAD pick up. Some direction coming from Langthorne. Master of corners, defending them. Not many people got goals from Richard Langthorne off corners, I tell you that. They've gone to the back post this time. Oof, he gets across but goes into the hands of Josh. That's a relief for the SCAD Bees fans. Takes his time. Well done, Josh. We see Tom Melville now carrying the ball. Goes second. Good ball. Sassy's. Well, it's a bit of argument between the SCAD 12 and the number 6 of Georgia Gwinnett. Luckily they're speaking in their native language, so the referee can't understand what they're saying. Because I've picked up some words and I can assure you it's not very nice what they're saying to each other. And Gwinnett come down. Ooh, I'll tell you what, this lad's fast. Once again, who's there? The guy from Barcelona, Sergio Suarez, cleans up the play. What an excellent game he's had. All this fruit he's eaten is obviously paying off. Sergio Suarez is like Brad Pitt off Ocean's 11. Oh, I tell you what. He got very lucky then. Ball came over, hit him on the hand inside the box. Gwinnett screaming out for handball, which it could have been, but the referee gives a corner, and the away side are not happy with that decision. Scar get let off the hook. There's 1 minute 16, but it's a corner. They need to pick up. Number three at the back. Some movement. It's a good ball in. But it's good by Josh. Big, big hand from Josh Brown. But takes a shot, and that goes wide to the left post. 58 seconds. I think Scad are going to see this one out to extra time. Maybe they get one last push here. Get a flick from Trincy. It's a flick from Inaki. This could be the last chance. I'll tell you what. Oh, but the keeper clears his line. Well done. Well done, Sese. It's good defending, and that's going to be the last we see. Oh, it's been a feisty little end to the half. And that's it. It's going to be tied 2-2 after 90 minutes, and we're going to go into extra time. There's going to be a short break, and I'll be right back with you. Reminder, this is golden goal. So all it takes is one goal, a moment of excellence. Something scrappy, you never know. Goes up wide. Taylor Katsanis gets his first touch of extra time. Plays the ball into Sasse. But it's just fired in between Sasse and Torin. Georgia Gwinnett regain possession. Ooh, they got lucky with that, I tell you. Oliver cleans up. And Torin Melville out on the left. Plays the ball. But it's easily picked up by the Gwinnett centre half, number six, who I must say is got better as the game's gone on, but Naki, oof. Tom Melville picks a ball up with space. Oh. Gwinnett get the game back underway after a sloppy pass. Good defending. Away by Sergio Suarez. And Inaki gets a ball. Very calm. It's a great ball by Naeem in behind the right full, left full back, sorry. And who's that making hard work? AJ. Is it AJ or Jordan Chambers? It's Jordan Chambers and Jordan Trinity teaming up there. And it's a scad throw. Angus on the ball. He's to a switch. But Ollie carries the ball out. Tell you what, he's gonna he fancies his chance. Takes a shot, but it goes 20 foot wide. Hey, he deserved that. He's worked hard. Gets a sight of goal. Fancies his chances. Unfortunately, it didn't work out. Going for the glory in the extra time. Now it's a Georgia Gwinnett goal kick. A good flick. Oh, what's going on here? I'm sorry, I didn't get a chance to catch up, but something happened off the ball. And the referee's given a free kick 30 yards out. Scad need to get organised here. This could be dangerous. It must have been something bad because it got Ollie put into the book. It's been given a yellow card. The ball was gone, so I'm guessing it was something off the ball. We've got two over it. Surely it's too far to score. I said 30 yards. You're probably 35, 40. And he does play a chip into the penalty spot, but it's away by Jordan Trinity line. Oh, it's a bit of ping pong going on. Oh, and Scad, the referee, he was like the Matrix there. And the ball crossed in, that's a great ball. It's a free header. Oh, and Gwinnett have scored. Georgia Gwinnett get the golden goal. What a terrible way to end the game. As you can hear, the Gwinnett fans next to me are obviously happy about the game. Well, Georgia Gwinnett wrap up a win. That's good night from me and good night from the Scad Bees.